Hello, it's Jessica. Today I've got a little painting. It's going to be watercolor. It's going to be of a moon. It's going to be a Halloween scene. So let's get started. The color I'm using is indigo. I'm actually working on painting. The center is going to be the moon, and the indigo that I'm using is going to be like the night sky. Just trying to get my basic shape of how far I want everything to go over. Using a different kind of paper. I've never used this paper before. So we will see how the paper fans out. Paint I'm using is Holbein. And I'm not using a wet on wet technique either. My brush is pretty saturated with color, but I did not wet the paper first. Just putting a few hints of a different shade of blue in here, just just to break up the color a little bit, make it a little more interesting. And I'll give it some time to dry. Okay, it's now dry, and so I'm gonna go back in and add some more indigo to it and just deepen that color a little bit more. I did not wet the paper. Feels like the paper's still just a little bit wet. It's still buckled. And as I said before, this is a different paper too, so we'll see how it reacts. This was just a sample pack that I had picked up, and I thought, I'm gonna see how it does before I buy any of it. If I did probably purchase it, it would probably be a block. Deepening that indigo. I've got very little water on the brush. I have just pretty much wet my brush and then going in with some heavy pigment. Now I'm going to wet my brush a little more and just kind of, I'm going to pick out another color and wet this up just a little bit. See how I'm actually probably just moving around the pigment on the paper, and it's adding just a few highlights in there. Now I'm going to go in with a little bit of a brighter blue, and I'm just going to tap it in. Just so it shows just a little bit of difference in color. Darken up the edges a bit more on this one side. So let me clean that little brighter blue off and go back into my indigo and work on that outer edge just a little bit, just to darken it. Just want to tap in some color. And make sure I get that corner of the paper. All right, and I think now I'm gonna let it dry, and it needs to completely dry this time, because next time I'm going to use wet on wet technique and wet the whole moon. So I'll bring you back when it's completely dry. Okay, it feels like for the most part it is completely dry. And so now I'm going to take one of my brushes and I'm gonna begin wetting the whole inside of the moon. I'm going to start dropping some color in. I'm actually going to go and I added some white to my palette. This white is not a, it's actually not a watercolor. It is a gouache. Just going to put some in, just random. clean my brush, and then we're gonna go in with some indigo. Just kinda here and there. And in my reference photo, it's pretty dark down here at the bottom. This is just to kinda, and I'm gonna kinda go in around the edges and darken it up. It's almost like, now I'm gonna pick this up and just kind of bounce it down to try to keep it loose. Things random. We'll add a little bit more up here, but a little more on the faded side. Looks like there's just scooping up some of the water. Wet this brush just a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna add, got a smaller brush now, I'm just gonna go in and add some more indigo in various spots, just to darken it up just a bit, give it a little more contrast. And I'm just gonna kind of skip around and turn my brush in different directions so it doesn't look all uniform. This outside edge here. And just clean it up just a little bit. Darken it. Darker towards the bottom. Just going by my reference photo, it's much, much darker. I definitely need to add a little bit more water to my brush. It's looking pretty uniform, and we don't really want it to look uniform. We want it to look just random. It's a nice Halloween kind of picture. Contrast to it. There's, at this point, there is more of the color, then water in my brush. Looks like I'm going to give it just a little bit more time to dry, and next time when I come back, we are going to wet the areas that are still white and add some gouache on here. So I'll bring you back when it's ready to, it's completely dry. Okay, it looks like it's almost completely dry. I'm just gonna take one of my big brushes, a flat, and I'm gonna go into my white, the gouache. It is not watercolor, it is gouache. And I'm just gonna go in and place in some extra white. Let me get dampen my brush just a little bit. Almost like a wash. Leave it in thick in some places. All right, I have put the white in, so now I'm gonna completely let this dry, and then I'm going to come back and do a tree in the middle for Halloween, a haunted looking tree. Okay, it's time to get started and paint the tree in. I am actually going to start with a number 4 round, and I'm going to mix up, look at my color swatch here. I'm actually going to go, I think, and mix up some indigo. Persian blue, and mixing. And let's try some burnt leather. It's going to cut out nicely. Get a little bit more burnt umber. A little bit more indigo. And a little bit more Persian blue. All right, let me get started. Done just a little outline here to kind of give me an idea. I'm not sure if I'm still gonna follow it for sure. Thank you. I'm gonna switch brushes and use this number two. This is a liner brush. I think I'm gonna grab me some black and mix in and darken this up. Or let's even get some, let me get a different shade. Let me put some green in it. That'll, or even some purple. Let's put some purple in it. I'm gonna deepen the colors. I'm gonna go in and add some black, and then I'll bring you back for the final product. All right, guys. There we go. I'm gonna go in, I think, and add just a little bit more white wash. Just around some of the seams where the moonlight is shining through. Just around some of the branches. Which is just gonna go and highlight the tree a little bit more. This haunted tree. Guys, I think I'm finished. So I hope you enjoy it, and I hope you try to do your own haunted tree.